everybody. Today I am going to deal with the study of translation. The translation is very important in the study of literatures across the world. So many classic masterpieces are written in various languages. So they have been made accessible to all the readers belonging to different languages, different countries, through translation. And the study of translation has been considered as an inevitable segment within comparative literature, since they are the vital intermediaries establishing the link between two literatures in different languages. For example, works of art written in French, German, Chinese languages, so we come to know them through translation. And even India is a multilingual country, so literatures written in regional languages in India, we are able to read them through translation. J.K. Shah, a comparatist, states that to a comparatist, translations belong not only to the study of reception of a particular literature, but to the study of literature itself. So translation nowadays it is considered as a branch of literature itself. It is creative. So people may believe that it is just imitation or copying. It is translating from the original language to a target language. But now translation is considered as creative work. So according to J.T. Shah, translation is an important component of influence studies. So influence studies, because the scholars who read a classical masterpiece in language, they are influenced by that particular work of art, and they feel that they must make their people know about the masterpiece. So they go for translation. If the translator is either why the translator tries to translate a work. So the reason is either he is attracted with a work, or he is convinced that the translation in his own language is likely to satisfy the native readers. So the native readers who do not know the source language. So then it becomes a subject of influence studies. So the reader, the translator is influenced by that particular work of art. So he wants it to be known to his native readers. So he goes for translation. Then Wilhelm Humboldt describes translation as one of the labors most essential to any literature. So because it introduces to those ignorant of foreign languages to forms of art and humanity which otherwise they would never come to know. And this is an important gain for any nation. So people who are ignorant of foreign languages, so they come to know the classical masterpieces in foreign languages only through translation. And another reason is because the translation widens the capacity for meaning and expression possessed by one's own language. It increases the vocabulary of a particular language, so adding new words. There is a discussion, argument, whether translation is an art or a dependent work on the original. So there is controversy about this, but there are different opinions. There are cases of a translation closely following the original without being too literal. So translation, there are different types of translation. Some translators, they closely follow the original. And then there are literal renderings which look like mere exercises without any artistic qualities. That is word for word translation. So it is like exercise, just physical exercise. We do it mechanically. So 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. So like that here, you know, without any artistic qualities, just literal rendering. That is word for word. Then there are translations which are imaginative adaptation of the original. text adaptation, that is the translator, he may add or omit so whatever is possible. Yes, so translation is an important branch of study in comparative literature and in popularizing classical masterpieces in different languages.